हेलो स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। माय सेल्फ श्री के डी बोरसे सर, बायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट टीचर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी लर्न ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिसीज चैप्टर कंटेंट कंसेप्ट सेल्स ऑफ इम्यून सिस्टम। देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ सेल्स आर इन्वॉल्व इन इम्यून सिस्टम लाइक लिम्फोसाइट एंड एंटीजन प्रेजेंटिंग सेल्स। In previous lecture, we detail discuss lymphocyte as well as antigen presenting cells, also term vaccination and vaccine, different characteristics of vaccination. Today we are going to learn some more concept including human health and disease chapter contain concept like mechanism of response of B lymphocyte to antigens, also structure of antibody and formation of antigen antibody complex. So let us start today's first concept, mechanism of response of B lymphocyte to antigen. Mechanism of a response of B lymphocyte to antigen. B lymphocyte are sensitized by both antigen as well as helper T cells. Antigen as well as helper T cell stimulate B lymphocyte. Due to this, B lymphocyte are sensitized or activated. Such activated B lymphocyte produce clone of plasma cells. Activated lymphocyte produce clone of plasma cells or memory B cells. Such plasma cells produce specialized glycoprotein. Plasma cells produce specialized glycoprotein called as antibodies. You know, antibodies most important produce plasma cells, called them specialized glycoprotein. Antibody circulated through body fluid, humor like blood and lymph, means through blood and lymph. Antibody circulated through body fluid like blood and lymph. Such antibody is actual specialized glycoprotein produced from plasma cell, and such plasma cells are produced from activated B lymphocyte. Activated B lymphocyte are sensitized by maybe antigen as well as helper T cell. So point number 5, such antibody molecule may bind to B cell membrane or they remains free. Free antibody have three main function. You know, there are two types of antibody molecules. They may be bind cell membrane antibody, they remains free antibody. When free antibody have three main functions like agglutination, opsonization and neutralization, means free antibody show three types of functions: agglutination, opsonization, neutralization. We detail discuss one by one. First one is agglutination is one of the function performed by free antibodies. How perform agglutination function by free antibodies? Free antibody perform one of the function agglutination. How agglutination function perform free antibody? Free antibody immobilized foreign particles like bacteria and viruses, then engulfed by phagocytes. And this is one of the most important main function performed by free antibody, agglutination. Second one is opsonization. How opsonization function perform free antibodies? Coating of bacteria to facilitate the phagocytosis by macrophages. Coating of bacteria is one of the function performed by free antibodies, and such coating of bacteria to facilitate the phagocytosis by macrophages. You know, macrophages are done by phagocytosis process. So macrophages phagocytosis facilitated develop coating of bacteria. Such function is performed by free antibody molecule. Third one is neutralization. Neutralizing toxin released by bacteria, for example, tetanus toxin is one of the toxin released by bacteria. Such released toxin by pathogen as well as virus, bacteria are neutralized or neutralizing them by free antibody. So here noted, agglutination, opsonization and neutralization are different function performed by free antibody molecule. Up to this we detail discuss mechanism of response of B lymphocyte to antigen. Hope that you understood everything. Now we detail discuss antibody. What is antibody? Antibody is a protective chemical. What is antibody? Antibody is a protective chemical produced by immune cells in response to antigen. Antigen cha response ne immune cells produce kartat a protective chemical, and such protective chemicals can neutralize a specific antigen called as antibody. So antibody is a protective chemical produced by immune cells. Response to antigen can neutralize a specific antigen called them protective chemical or antibody. We detail discuss antibody about some basic information. Number one, first, antibody are glycoproteins which nature show in antibody. Glycoprotein nature show in the antibody. They are, means antibody are, highly specific to specific antigen. Specific antigen sati specific antibody asti. Number third, antibody also known as immunoglobulins, IgS. Antibody also known as immunoglobulins. Antibody produced by plasma cells. You know, antibody produced by plasma cells, which in turn are formed by B lymphocyte. Point number five, in mature plasma cell produce antibodies. In mature plasma cell produce antibodies at about 2000 molecule per second. Always remember how many molecule release per second antibody to 1000 molecule release antibody per molecule by plasma cells. अप टू दिस वी डिटेल डिस्कस सम बेसिक इन्फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. नाउ वी लर्न स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. हियर नोटेड दिस इज द एंटीबॉडी स्ट्रक्चर. लुक लाइक वाई शेप स्ट्रक्चर शो इन एंटीबॉडी. एंटीबॉडी हैज फोर चेन, टू आर वेरी लॉन्ग एंड आइडेंटिकल कॉल्ड एज हेवी चेन. दिस वन इज हेवी चेन. दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द हेवी चेन. सो टू हेवी चेन सीन इन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडी एंड टू लाइट चेन सीन इन एंटीबॉडी. दिस इज द लाइट चेन. दिस वन इज ऑल्सो लाइट चेन. And this long identical two are called as heavy chain. Means total four chain present in antibody. Each chain has two ends, C terminal end and N terminal end. So in light chain, same condition seen in heavy chain also. C terminal end and N terminal end seen here also. C terminal end, N terminal end, C terminal end, N terminal end. Two chain are very small in size called as light and two chain are very big in size called as heavy chain. Each chain show two regions, constant region of heavy chain. This is the constant region of heavy chain and this is the variable region of heavy chain. Means each chain show two region, constant region and variable region. So this is the constant region of heavy chain and this part is variable region of heavy chain. Light chain also show constant region of the light chain. This one is constant region of light chain and this one is variable region of light chain seen here. Both chains show two region, constant region and variable region. Both heavy chain are held together by disulfide bond. Seen here, disulfide bond are held together by both heavy chain. Here one heavy chain attached with a light chain molecule also attached by disulfide bond. Means here noted disulfide bond, this is also disulfide bond and due to disulfide bond light chain attached with heavy chain, also heavy chain attached with heavy chain. Stem of antibody, this is the stem of antibody and these are the arms of antibody. So stem of antibody held together arms at that point called as hing. This is the hing point of antibody structure. This one is also hing point of antibody structure because the stem part of the antibody is held together with arm parts. So such point called as hing point. Seen here, antigen binding site, N terminal end. This one is antigen binding site. This is also antigen binding site. How form antigen binding site? Variable region of heavy chain, also variable region of light chain perform antibody structure called as antibody bind antigen binding site. So a antibody show two antigen binding site. This one is also antigen binding site. This one is also antigen binding site. Structure of antibody, point number one. Structurally, antibodies Y-shaped molecule seen here. This is the Y-shaped molecule structurally seen in antibody. Each immunoglobulin means antibody. Each immunoglobulin means antibody molecule is made up of four polypeptide chains. Each antibody molecule made up of four polypeptide chain seen here. Diagrammatic representation. Two long and identical chains are called as heavy chain, and two short identical chain are called as light chain. Means total four polypeptide chains seen in a antibody molecule. Two heavy chain or H chain and two light chain or L chains, means total four polypeptide chains are present in structure of antibody. These two are heavy chain and these two are light chain. So total four polypeptide chains seen in structure of antibody. Four polypeptide chain are held together by disulfide bond to form Y-shaped structure. This Y-shaped structure is formed due to disulfide bond are held together heavy chain as well as heavy chain with light chain. So form a structure called as Y-shaped structure. And such Y-shaped structure are called as antibody structure. The region holding together arm and stem of antibody. The region holding together arm and stem of antibody is termed as hing. Seen here, diagrammatic representation. This part is a stem of antibody and these two parts are arms of antibody. So stem held together by arms at one point called as hing point. This is hing point and this one is also hing point. To this we detail discuss total four different points of structure of antibody. Point number five. Each chain of antibody include two distinct regions, variable region and constant region, seen here diagrammatic representation. This part is constant region of heavy chain and this part is constant region of light chain. This two parts means this is the variable region of heavy chain and this one is variable region of light chain. These two regions are held together by disulfide bond and this point is called as antigen binding site. Variable region use antigen binding site called as paratopes. This is the paratopes of antibody. This part is also paratopes of antibody. So a antibody can bind two types of antigen. Paratopes of antibody recognize and bind to the specific antigen. Means each antibody has two antigen binding site called them paratopes. Such paratope of antibody recognize antibody's a paratope part recognize karto and bind karto अस्पेसिफिक एंटीजन. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर पैराटोप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी रिकग्नाइज एंड बाइंड टू अ स्पेसिफिक एंटीजन. हियर क्लियरली सीन दिस वन इज एंटीजन बाइंडिंग साइट मीन्स पैराटोप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. दिस इज ऑल्सो पैराटोप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. सो पैराटोप ऑफ एंटीबॉडी रिकग्नाइज एंड बाइंड टू स्पेसिफिक एंटीजन टू फॉर्म एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी कॉम्प्लेक्स. सिंस मोस्ट एंटीबॉडी कैरी टू एंटीजन्स बिकॉज टू एंटीजन बाइंडिंग साइट प्रेजेंट ऑन स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. सो मोस्ट एंटीबॉडी कैरी टू एंटीजन्स बाइंडिंग साइट. दे आर कॉल्ड एज बायोवैलेंट. वाई एंटीबॉडी सेड टू बी बायोवैलेंट बिकॉज ईच एंटीबॉडी कैरी टू एंटीजन बाइंडिंग साइट. सो कॉल्ड देम बायोवैलेंट. अप टू दिस वी डिटेल डिस्कस डिफरेंट 8 points स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एंटीबॉडी. होप दैट यू अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग. नाउ वी लर्न फॉर्मेशन ऑफ एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी कॉम्प्लेक्स. फर्स्ट टर्म नोन एज सेरोलॉजी. व्हाट इज सेरोलॉजी? इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ इम्यूनोलॉजी. सेरोलॉजी इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ इम्यूनोलॉजी विच डील्स विथ स्टडी ऑफ एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी इंटरैक्शन. सेरोलॉजीमध्ये आपल्याला अभ्यास करता येतो स्टडी ऑफ एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी इंटरैक्शन. कॉल्ड एज सेरोलॉजी मीन्स सच ब्रांच कॉल्ड एज सेरोलॉजी. व्हाट इज मेन पर्पज ऑफ सेरोलॉजी? स्टडी ऑफ एंटीजन एंटीबॉडी इंटरैक्शन. कॉल्ड देम सेरोलॉजी. ईच एंटीबॉडी इज अ स्पेसिफिक फॉर अ पर्टिक्युलर एंटीजन. स्पेसिफिक एंटीजन साठी स्पेसिफिक एंटीबॉडी असते. सो ईच एंटीबॉडी इज अ स्पेसिफिक फॉर पर्टिक्युलर एंटीजन. कंबाइनिंग साइड ऑफ एंटीजन. कंबाइनिंग साइड ऑफ एंटीजन कॉल्ड एज एंटीजेनिक डिटर्मिनंट और इपिटोप्स. व्हाट इज इपिटोप्स? अ कंबाइनिंग साइड ऑफ एंटीजन कॉल्ड एज एंटीजेनिक डिटर्मिनंट और इपिटोप. सीनियर डायग्रामेटिक रिप्रेजेंटेशन. दिस इज वन ऑफ द एंटीजन. शो टू कंबाइनिंग साइट. This triangle one is combining side of antigen called them epitopes. This is also combining side of antigen called them epitopes. So epitopes are also called as antigen determinant. Antigenic determinant or epitopes. Number third, the antigen binding side of antibody. Antibody la ja location la antigen bind hoto. So antigen binding side of antibodies are called as paratope. Means paratope present in antibody and epitope present on the surface of antigen. How form an antigen antibody complex? Epitope of antigen reacts with antigen binding side of paratope. Epitope of antigen reacts with antigen binding side of paratope of the antibody in lock and key manner, forming antigen antibody complex. How form antigen antibody complex? You know, epitopes of antigen reacts with antigen binding site or paratopes of the antibody in lock and key manner, forming an antigen antibody complex. Seen here, this is the paratope of antibody and this one is epitope of antigen. So antigen antibody interaction process takes place due to epitopes of antigen reacts with antigen binding site paratope of antibody in lock key manner called as antigen antibody complex. A review of today's topic. We learn in today's lecture mechanism of response of B lymphocyte to antigen, structure of antibody, formation of antigen antibody complex. On the basis of today's lecture, some exercise question noted here, MCQ question. An antibody has dash dash heavy chains and dash dash light chain respectively. 2, 4, 4, 2, 2, 2 and 1, 2. The correct answer is an antibody has dash dash heavy chains and dash dash light chain respectively, two heavy chains and two light chains present in antibody. So correct option is C, 2, 2. Second MCQ, the chain of antibody are held together by dehydration covalent ionic bond, disulfide bond. Yes, the correct answer is chains of antibody are held together by disulfide bond. Antibodies are produced by plasma cells, RBCs, paratopes both A and B. Yes, the correct answer is antibodies are produced by plasma cells. Short answer question. Why antibody said to be bivalent? Because a antibody carry two antigen binding site, so called them bivalent. What is serology? It is a branch of immunology which deals with study of antigen-antibody interaction called as serology. How form antigen-antibody complex? Yes, epitopes of antigen reacts with paratope of antibody to form a antigen antibody complex. Fourth question, combining site of antigen called as, yes, combining site of antigen called as epitopes. The mature plasma cell produce antibody at about dash dash molecules per second. Yes, 2000 molecule per second produce antibodies by mature plasma cell. The antigen binding site of antibody are called as paratope. Antigen binding site of antibody are called as paratope. Identify the diagram and labeled A, B, C and D. Yes, this is the structure of antibody diagram labeled A, B, C and D. Here A means constant region of heavy chain This is the constant region of heavy chain. B, variable region of light chain. This is the variable region of light chain. C, antigen binding site, also called them paratope. D, disulfide bond, both light chain and heavy chain held together by one another, called them disulfide bond. Up to this, today's lecture completed. Hope that you understood everything. If you like the video, then you can subscribe my YouTube Bio Info channel, tap the bell icon and like the video. If any doubt about today's lecture, mention in comment box. Thank you.